The book wasn't just buried. The whole Grand Library was abandoned. In this revered place. More of his father's secrets. But for now, he had found the book. The other mysteries would have to wait. Reggie wished King Ratus were with him, to explain these creatures being here. And, if he were being honest, because he missed his father's reassuring presence. The bard had found a little courage, and even better, he'd found a key. Finally, a way out of these hellish halls. Thank you. This room was strangely well preserved. The lack of rubble showed how bare it was, like something was missing. This statue almost seemed to glow. It belonged somewhere it could be seen and appreciated. This cheese was unusually pungent, but perhaps Chef would be able to use this in his recipes. In tiny amounts. The distant smells of fresh whole bug bread led them home. The bard swore to write a heroic song of the pair's quest. Reggie wondered what would rhyme with zombie. Reggie didn't tell his brother of the undead yet. They still had living enemies to fight, weapons to forge, and a book full of blueprints thought to be lost. Stories could wait. Though the kitchen and smithy were restored and improved, Reggie looked at his broken, gore-smeared throne room. No self-respecting king could rule from here. The costs, as usual, never went down. the old rat was willing to part ways with his compass for the right price. This fine compass was ideal for a ranger tracking beasts in the wild. The compass had guided the ranger to new hunting grounds. He gave his first kill to the king in gratitude. The chef's cellar would soon be overflowing. What was this strange creature? Everything about it unsettled him. He must be cautious. was dead. But Reggie was no less unsettled. He had a sense it was not yet fully grown. He hoped this was the last of these he'd see. The Mozzie King. Smaller than his female counterpart, but just as ferocious. Buzzing, then the stench of rotten meat. The Mozzie King had come for him. He wasn't the only king with a sting in his tail. With the king dead, hopefully the waves of Mozzie infestations would slow down. Her offspring were all dead, and the mother had come to get her revenge.
Thank you.
the Mozzie Queen, foul mother of the swarm. They've never stopped what she the mother dead, that should be the last of them. For now. Now he had a throne room to be proud of. Not like his father's, but he was his own king, doing things differently. Not hiding zombies in the crypt, for example. The kingdom was restored, but Reggie could not enjoy peace until he knew it was free of threats. It was only restored above. Miners had sighted frogs below. Some were no longer willing to work. His squire thought it might have more to do with a strange rumbling. They say a monster prowls beneath. Dennis brought worrying news. The war chief and his band of pond scum had been sighted in the mine. The king was lucky. The woodcutter had just finished cutting the planks and was willing to strike a deal. Frogs were dealt with, and Reggie had felt no rumbling monster. But sighting the war chief had made Reggie realize they needed to prepare for an attack. A king was needed in the fort. The bridge cracked under his weight. The darkness stretched endlessly below. But Reggie had a kingdom to fight for. He couldn't go back. So he had no choice but to go on. There had to be another way out. Thank you.
Reggie marveled that such crisp greens could grow underground. The chef would make a fine meal of this. The deeper the king got, the older the mines looked, as if the rats had found the tunnels, not made them. But what could dig better than a rat? What was this device? What it was for and who put it here were a mystery, but one thing he could see plain enough, it was missing a piece. Maybe something so strange should have scared him, but it only made him want to know what would happen if he restored it. looked like the piece the device needed. Now he could open the gate, he hoped. By another's invisible paw. What strange world lay beyond? Whoever had lived here was long gone, and Reggie was glad. What kind of beast would live in a place made of such cold, hard metal? Comrade, the little creature squeaked at Reggie. What was it? Not a rat or mouse. It was armed, but seemed pleased to see him. Maybe it could help the king get home. Having said that he was king, the creature explained that he was a mole and electrician of the great Bolshevik Republic. But little of this made sense to Reggie. The mole needed something called electricity for his tram. It could get Reggie home, and that was all he needed to know to agree to help. That gave electricity must be beyond this room. But they'd have to get past the Grubmother first. She was the one infesting the mines with her grublings.
Thank you.
finally stopped buzzing. She and her young would infest this place no longer. Now the electricity was back, the little mole would take them on his tram. Reggie was sure a tram was the rumbling creature the miners had. His new friend called it Station 24-7. It was kept alive with their electricity. Pipes funneled away the toxic gas, and there was strange music to put a wag in his tail. It was unlike anything Reggie had ever seen or dreamt possible. The guard moles refused to let Reggie pass. They were too busy arguing about what cake to bring to their captain's birthday. Caramelized whole grub or cheesecake? Another statue. There must be a better place for it. Thank you. This foe was called Mole Mysterio by the crowd. Wondered what name the crowd would give him if he returned to the arena again. The fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. The fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. The fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. The fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. Fighter they called Macho Mole was a crowd favorite. Many a mole has lost their head to the brutal swing of his axe. Victory in the arena felt good. Maybe Reggie could learn to like this. This strange device was a blaster. Molecraft more deadly than most bows. Reggie wondered what the smith would think. This strange device was a blaster. All craft more deadly than most bows. Reggie wondered what the smith would think. Blasters make short work of most enemies. The king could get used to this. Mole held the award for crispiest fried crisp bugs, but his reserves of cooking oil were all gone. Whatever was lurking in the old sector had him too scared to collect more. To show. This automobile could dig them a path anywhere and fast, even to the Crimson Fort, but it needed to be fed petrol, which the mole said Reggie could get in station 24/7, but it was not cheap nor easy. No change there then, the king thought.
Thank you.
fighting pits, where the victors were legend and the vanquished were stains on the floor. These arenas were outlawed in his kingdom. When his mole friend said, not easy, he didn't think he'd meant possibly fatal. But it was the only way to get coin for petrol. It was the only way home.
Reggie had chosen well. Cheesecake was his kingdom's national dish, after all. Singing, the guard moles went to start celebrating, leaving Reggie to explore the old sector. The old sector had been left to its ruin and to grubs. Fresh cooking oil. Maybe now he could try the mole's fried crisp bugs. This was the fuel pump Jay spoke of, though it didn't seem to be working. Maybe, like the tram, it too needed electricity to work. Thank you. Reggie didn't know what this creature was, but its teeth and claws were as sharp as they were fast. Reggie wondered what this feeling it inspired was. Fear or despair? It was dead, and Reggie could barely believe he'd survived. He hoped this would be the last one he encountered. The pump was working. Time to get this fuel back to Jay for his automobile. fresh oil, the mole was able to fry his crisp bugs again. He cooked a batch for Reggie. The king made a note to ask the chef to put these on his menu. The king was tired and bruised, but he had the precious petrol. This might be a place of wonder, but it had none of the warmth of home. Something was wrong. The Crimson Fort was locked down with guards at every door. The king had been away too long. The enemy had returned, just as he'd feared, but sooner than he'd have believed. They'd slithered in through a broken pipe in the crypts. His brother and the Rat Guard had driven them back, for now. His brother Dennis pointed the way. He'd meet them below at the broken pipe. Together, they would end the frog scourge for good. His new mole friend offered to stay and help Comrade Reggie with this fight. If the Rat Kingdom fell, Mole Town would surely follow. A traditional Mole Town burger. It had an unusual texture, but it was hearty fare